In this episode, we'll be venturing inside Hudson River State Asylum, which dates back all the way to the 1800s, closing in early 2000s, with an amazing, beautiful architecture of a Gothic style. See up there, there's the old stairs. You're officially trespassing. Trespassing.
Well, we're not going to spend the whole day here, that's for sure.
Why?
Because we're pushing it if we do.
You mean this building?
Just in this whole complex.
Oh, we are?
I think so. It's not like Witchworth. Second floor. lines of pine trees.
And why the hell we did all that when we could have just...
Could have came right over.
Yeah. Look at the smoke coming off the ground right there.
Oh, yeah. That's cool.
Oh, shit.
Matter.
We're in, like, the main section of this building.
Yeah, there's the main door.
Right here. This place and its history freaks me the hell out.
I can't make it crazy, but yeah.
It's the wind. It was at this point in our exploration where we realized we were not alone.
Yeah, so
what we were about to face would definitely scare us to unbelief.
Not totally sure what it is yet, but we're gonna keep pushing on and look around a little bit more. there's gonna be anybody out here. See, that's where we want to get. We want to get in those buildings. And it's intact.
You okay?
Yeah. I just saw something flare. We gonna keep going down there?
Yeah, I wanna get on the other side then.
No.
It's fairly new. Definitely not original.
Holy crap.
Fixtures. If every bulb was good, then you know they somehow came in or they used them or something. Chances are, as you know, they'd be blown out, broken.
All right, you want to move on?
Yeah, just let me go. I have to go back to you.
I don't know what to
see if there's a date on these.
2000?
I think that's a model.
control room.
It was at this point in our exploration where we realized we were not alone. What we were about to face would definitely scare us to unbelief.
I don't want to deal with the haunted. Shit. Yeah, we see active cars and they turn their brake lights on. So they know we're here.
Sir.
We got two cars watching us.
You watch behind us, I'll watch in front of us. Yeah, so currently we are still exploring. We've had a couple jump scares. I don't know. We saw two active vehicles, people sitting in them. Now we're just gonna hide out for a minute.
Only took 30-40 minutes, but we're finally in a building. doesn't go anywhere. This is the roof. Whoever these people are, we knew they had a dog. We didn't know what type of dog, but it sounded like a beagle, which meant if we were caught, we could possibly be attacked. So we decided to hide out in one of the buildings until the ghost was clear. Unfortunately, the ghost wasn't exactly clear. So we decided to introduce ourselves.
Just want to feel this out a little bit here. When beagles attack, they seem, I think they're going that way. Because we came that way.
He's closer than they think, though. So his bark is bouncing off of that building.
He's probably right in the middle.
He's right in the center.
The front one was caught by lightning.
By lightning.
And it caught on fire.
So this one was deliberately set?
I don't honestly know. I don't know a lot about it.
see, unfortunately, we are in the car, and we've had to vacate the premises because we were in a building, and I happened to... Actually, we were out in the back of the building trying to get from one building to another, and I just happened to catch a man kind of crossing out on the road through the woods. And it turns out he had a dog with him. So it was a bloodhound beagle, which obviously picked up our scent. And, you know, we confronted them. We thought that would be the best thing to do, to let them know that we were there. They seemed pretty decent. They asked us to, you know, to leave the premises, which we gladly did. We don't, you know, the best thing to do is to be compliant. We don't try to cause any problems or do the wrong thing. So we kind of knew this going forward, coming here, because, you know, it's very heavily patrolled, and it's pretty much in the center of a town, so there's a lot of traffic, there's restaurants, shopping centers, so, obviously, and we also found it very windy up there today, which was a problem, because there was so much noise of the wind going through the trees, we couldn't tell if they were cars, or... You know, you can hear wood cracking, so things like that. So,
yeah, we got busted. They took some of our information. One of the guys walked us out, escorted us to the end, and then we said we would never come back, and we're heading home now.
Yeah, so unfortunately, we didn't get all the coverage we wanted. It would have been a little hard anyway, because a lot of buildings are under construction and remodeling. Most of them are pretty much very dangerous to either falling down or they're completely boarded up and there'd be no way in there. So we kind of got what we went for, I think. And
yeah, it was a success. It was a success and a failure, but
yeah,
it was good.
It was good. So, you know, these are the things you have to be prepared for. It could have turned out worse. You know, and that's the whole reason to kind of be compliant and not break somebody's chops. Just vacate as quickly as you can.